Hi guys, and welcome back to the CGSL. In today's video, I will show you how to create these kind of cursors. It's quite simple, and also at the request from one of my subscribers. First of all, we select the rectangle tool and create the pattern. That has a width of 500 mm and the height is 50 mm. Next, using the Edit Pattern tool, we select the top edge of the pattern, press the right mouse button, we choose the Split command in the pop-up menu. In the Split option menu, we split uniformly into 10 pieces. After that, we have 11 points. The same process we repeat to the bottom edge. When we have points on the bottom and top, we will connect them using internal polygon line tool. Next, select the internal edge which is created and press the right mouse button and choose the option Cut. Select the pattern after one and delete it. This is our cornice, so we have to freeze it. Press the right mouse button and choose the option Freeze or use the hard key Ctrl F. It's time to create the main pattern. It's quite simple. Select the rectangle tool and create the rectangle, which have the width 200 mm and the height maybe 2000 mm. Now we must sew the pieces of curtain to pieces of the cornice together. But firstly, we need to specify the place of the sewing. Select the right and the left edge of the pattern and split them. The length has to be 50 mm, like the height of our cornice. Then we connect those two points using the internal polygon line tool. After we connect the points, we have to split connected and the top edge into three pieces, one big piece in the middle and the two smaller on the sides. To do that, select the Edit Pattern tool and select the Split option. Enter the value 35 and press OK. Using the internal polygon line tool, we connect the point that we just created. All we have to do is duplicate the buttons four times and sew it to the cornice. Let's duplicate it. Select the button and use the hotkey Ctrl-C to copy and Ctrl-V to paste it, or Ctrl-D, but if you will use this command, you will have some problem with the sewing, as I have. After we have all necessary buttons, we can sew it all together. Select the Sewing Segment tool, and we begin from the first button and we'll move from left to right. Now I'm sewing the internal line to the cornice, and after that I will sew the pattern of the curtains to each other. In the 3D view, I select the patterns and move a little bit. That helps simulation. Also, I made the curtain is too long. I select them and make them a little bit shorter. The main idea is that the bottom edge of the curtain should be above the ground plane. Now press the space bar and the simulation begins. And here a little problem. If you're using the Ctrl-D command when making the duplication, so you have a problem as I have. Now we fix it. It's happened because the symmetric pattern is on. To fix it, select the pattern that has blue highlights and press the right mouse button. Choose the options Remove Linking Editing. It's break connection and now you can sew the segment freely. We start our simulation again. Press the space bar, fixing some small problems, and the curtain is done. While we are in the simulation mode, we tweak a little bit of our pattern to make the wave look like we want. Almost done. We have left to do the couple things. One is to change the physical property of fabric to make it stiffer. To do that, I simply change the presets of fabric in the fabric panel and choose the preset cotton canvas. But you can experiment with the presets and choose the best for you. And two is increase the resolution and add more wrinkles. Select the pattern of our curtains and in the property editor find the property called particle distance and enter the lower number. In my case it will be 10. Press the space bar and let the simulation do its job. I hope you liked this video. Hit the subscribe button if you don't do this already and leave the comment below. If you have some requests, feel free to ask. Do my best. See you in the next video. Bye and good simulation to you.